Hey friends, mainframe and midrange computers have been reliably powering enterprises for decades. But as enterprises experience the benefits of the cloud, they ponder what to do with these aging systems, especially their data. Cristina Potra is here to show me how Microsoft is helping customers map out their mainframe and midrange modernization strategies today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm chatting with Cristina Potra about mainframe and mid-range modernization. Cristina, it's been a very long time since I've seen a mainframe, and the last time I saw it was a giant refrigerator box in a room. Can I put that in the cloud?
Yes, you can. It will be in a smaller box as we do have tools and we have procedures to actually take the workloads that are sitting currently on those mainframes and migrate them to Azure, running on Azure VMs.
Really? Wow. So I know that Microsoft has been doing this with mainframe customers for like 12 years. So this isn't a new thing. This is an experienced practice.
Yes, it is. We've been doing it for 12 years. The new part of it is we're migrating those customers to Azure as before we would migrate them to Windows on-prem. So we know how to do it. We have a good understanding of the partner ecosystem. We're heavily relying on partners for both ISV solutions and the migration capabilities. And those partners have been doing this for, as you said, for a while. The novelty of it is now we're migrating to Azure, which it's the novelty of it. I wouldn't know how to do this as well.
Yeah, this is hugely powerful. I used to work in banking and online banking, and I know that 96 of the world's top 100 banks run on mainframes. So like mainframes make the world run, and the cloud also does too. So this seems like a marriage made in heaven. This seems like a perfectly good idea.
Right. Yeah. Actually, in fact, 70% of the world GDP runs on mainframes today. And we do see, as you mentioned, a lot of those mainframes in the banking industry, mm-hmm. as well as in government and manufacturing, and a lot of enterprise, they still run business critical applications on mainframes or midrange today.
Very cool. So I understand that you have a slide that can maybe help me understand how we can move these workloads into the cloud.
Yes. So we have various solutions for customers because those mainframe workloads are highly customized. And customers have various immediate pain points that they want to mitigate longer term goals. And we're trying to find a solution that best fits their needs. So for customers that are not ready to leave their mainframes, but they want to take advantage of cloud capabilities, we're offering paths in a bucket that we call interop. Sit on your mainframe and connect your mainframe to the cloud, start experiencing taking advantage of Azure services and capabilities, and enhance your mainframe with cloud services. That's one option. And we have various paths within that option, highly relying on ISV solutions to migrate, but also have a first-party solution for that option. For customers that are ready to offload their mainframe workloads to Azure, we also have multiple solutions because of their readiness to transform and modernize. Some customers just want to lift and shift quickly their workload as it is from a mainframe to an Azure VM. So we do that. We offer those customers an emulation path where we have emulation running on Azure VMs, running COBOL code, and running all the workloads as they are. For customers that are ready to take a next step, and they want to get rid of the COBOL code and they want to modernize, we have another option, which basically takes COBOL, converts to Java or .NET, recompiles, and runs on VMs. So that's something that we call transform. They're ready to get rid of the COBOL and move those workloads to a more modern programming language. And then for those customers that are ready to re-envision that whole workload, we are partnering with them and helping them rewrite everything cloud native. Of course, this is the longest path as far as time, but it is the end goal. All the customers actually aim to fully modernize their workloads eventually.
Wow, that's really cool. I didn't realize that there were so many and so granular number of choices. Like, I just assumed it was simply a lift and shift. So I was assuming it was really offload and migrate, but there's lots of choices depending on the customer and depending on the mainframe or mid-range machine that they're using. And you say that these ISVs then provide emulators. So we can pretend to be a mainframe in the cloud, or we can transform that code and basically use the logic that the people have written historically and run it within a different context in Java or .NET.
Exactly. And besides you offering those tools, we're working with those ISVs and at the engineering level to make sure that we cater to the customer demands and plan for future enhancements of their tools. On the other side, we're also working on our Azure platform to make sure that we're catering to those customers coming off of mainframe workloads as far as our compute, storage, networking, and data needs, so that we meet or exceed the requirements that the mainframe has with Azure services.
Now, it's been a long time since I've seen, you know, worked on a mainframe. I know, again, that they do run a huge part of the world, but they were huge 30, 40 years ago. Are they still considered huge? Do mainframes do things in the order of petabytes, or are mainframes small compared to the cloud?
There's a variety. We do have, so we measure the size of a mainframe in MIPS. And we do have a variety of mainframes going from 100 MIPS, which we consider a very small one, to 300,000 MIPS. So if you look at the size, a small mainframe is somewhere in between 0 and 2,000 MIPS. A medium is up to 50,000 MIPS. And then large, we consider more than that. Now, right, of course, depending on the size, we do have to perform various optimizations. And when we think about the solution with the customer, we do take that into account.
Right. Now, MIPS is millions of instructions per second. And that's been a name, that's been it's not a really an accurate measurement of performance, but it's meant to indicate that a mainframe can do this much work. But don't we think about things in terms of billions on, you know, desktop PCs? But I can't replace a mainframe with my desktop computer.
Right, you can, unless it's a very, so we had an actual customer with a workload of 200 MIPS where you could replace it with a desktop computer. But in general, we have, so most of those big workloads, we use our specialized larger SKUs, the H series, to feed them in, and make sure that we still meet the requirements. And for the smaller ones, they go on our regular fleet.
Interesting. And then mainframes aren't just about raw processing in the terms of MIPS and millions of instructions per second, but it's also about data, right? It's about massive amounts of data. And they might be running ZOS, DB2. They might be running, you know, virtual storage access method, VSAM. Do we have a path, a target for all of those different data workloads?
We do. Actually, so if we look at the customers that are preferring a lift and shift solution, running on emulation or maybe even a code conversion, we do have DB2 VSAM running in Azure. For customers that are ready to modernize, we see them more interested in migrating the data as well to an Azure, like SQL, for example, Cosmos DB. So we do have paths both ways. If they want to stay on their data legacy system for a good reason, we offer that. If they are ready to modernize, we walk the journey with them, depending on what they want to do.
Now, when in the cloud offers elasticity, and with that elasticity, you get performance and also huge cost savings. But a mainframe is a box, and it's a box with a fixed amount of perf, and it doesn't scale up and down. Is this an opportunity for someone to save money by moving into the cloud? Because a mainframe may be underutilized.
Totally, exactly. And that's one of the value props that we have for our customers. Based on deployments that we've done so far, the cost savings are huge, up to 80% when they move off of a mainframe to cloud. And that is, they're expensive. They're expensive. And they're, like you said, they're sometimes underutilized, and scaling a mainframe means sometimes buying a new box. So between the price of hardware, licensing, software, maintenance, and all, moving to Azure is a way more efficient path.
Wow. Maybe you can show me the guidance that we have. I know that there's a bunch of documentation in the architecture section of Microsoft Learn to talk about both Azure mainframe and mid-range architecture design. I was surprised at how deep it was. I love discovering parts of the cloud that I didn't know existed, but the fact that it's running a huge part of the world and that Azure has a solution is pretty cool.
Sure. And I want to share the collection of reference architecture that the team is producing. So think about those as recipes. We have a variety of options depending on the customer situation. So for each of those, the team is creating the patterns, the reference architectures to help customers and to help partners and to help the whole ecosystem understand how would a mainframe workload look like, for example, in Azure using a Raincoat solution, or how would a mainframe look like in Azure using a Cisco solution. So you will have find, this is a collection, and we have about 20 plus reference architectures already published. We're still working on publishing more as we discover more solutions out there and to coming to fix particular problems that our customers have. We're always enhancing our solutioning.
Yeah. And as you pointed out, you mentioned Raincoat, which is a mainframe to cloud native partner. And there's lots of different partners with different solutions on how to get, whether it be your IBM mainframe into the cloud or whatever you have. There's a whole bunch of operating systems, mainframe and mid-range solutions. So no one will be left behind, it sounds like, in the cloud.
Exactly. We work with, we do migrations for IBM mainframes. We do migrations for Unisys mainframes. We're also working with mid-range customers. We have solutions for AIX for 4S400 customers running on power systems. We have solutions for Solaris. So there's a wide variety of options for customers.
Very cool. So we've got mainframe migration framework. We've got potential rehosting. We've got app modernization, data modernization, and there's a whole ton of architectural documentation to explain how one could start planning that. And they would just start at the Microsoft Learn Center, or should they engage with their Microsoft partner?
We have various ways. So sometimes it's the partner that they're engaging with a partner. Sometimes they come straight to us. And the fact that we have this pocket of engineers in Microsoft that are actually experts on both mainframe technology as well as Azure, we do offer a lot of technical expertise and help for those customers, regardless of where they're coming from. We work with customers themselves that they're doing the modernization within their own IT departments. We're working with partners that they are migrating customers. We're working with ISVs. So we're there to make sure that the customer lands smoothly in Azure and we have the right solution for that to address their particular problem.
Very cool. Well, thank you so much, Cristina Potra, for chatting with me today.
Thanks for the opportunity.
And certainly, my friends, we know that mainframes are only a part of the overall landscape and the digital transformation. So if you want to learn more, you can email legacy2azure@microsoft.com to learn more. And we're going to have links in the show notes to all of the different things that Cristina showed us. And I'm learning all about mainframe and mid-range modernization in Azure today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.